My name is Red, and this is my city, New York City. Some people see it as the city of dreams, the place where you can see your favorite celebrity on the billboard. For me, I see it as a place where I live, a place where I struggle, a place where I pay my bills. I pass New Yorkers in the street every day and never know their struggle. I never know their story. Like this lady, she on the phone with her boyfriend. Are they texting each other? Maybe I'm buying a perfect gift for a friend. Maybe I'm working hard. And this guy, maybe he overslept. Real tired, missed his stop. But me, I love New York City. This is the place where I live. I invite you to take this journey with me into the lives of everyday New Yorkers. ATBMJ presents New York City Life.
John Boy.
And how old are you?
31.
Where are you from?
Originally Chicago, Illinois, but living in Manhattan.
Manhattan. How'd you get to Manhattan from Chicago?
That's a good question. I came here because I've always wanted to live in New York City. It's always been a dream of mine, so, you know.
What about New York City made you want to live here?
Wow, excitement. You know, I live for excitement, and this city has it all. Best food, best music, best fashion, best art, best people.
So how long have you been living here?
I've been here for about 8 months now.
And what did you come out here to do?
I came out here to do some tattooing.
How long have you been tattooing?
Been tattooing 11 years now.
And how did you start out tattooing? Like, what made you want to be a tattooer?
I've always been into art when I was younger, but my grandfather, who was in the Navy, had tattoos on him, and that's what sparked the interest. I remember growing up thinking one day I'm gonna get a tattoo just like my grandpa.
So how did you actually get into doing tattoos?
I tried and tried for so long, and it seemed like every door I knocked on said, you don't want to be tattooing, you don't want to learn how to do this, or you know, it was just really hard to get in, until one day I was in a shop in Iowa, and this old biker guy, you know, wanted me to hang out, and I was answering phones and cleaning the shop, and one day said, hey, you want to do an apprenticeship? So I did an apprenticeship with Kevin Fitzgerald. So he taught me how to tattoo.
And what is an apprenticeship?
An apprenticeship, pretty much, someone who is skilled in taking you under their wing and, teaching you everything from making needles, mixing inks, building your machines, to how to design a tattoo right and how to put it on skin and keeping things clean and sterile.
And how long does someone have to apprentice for before they can actually work as a tattooer?
I think that's up to the teacher. I apprenticed for about a year and a half before I could touch skin. So.
How do you apprentice without touching skin?
You know, a lot of tracing and just a lot of knowing what the tools you're using before you can apply it on skin. But really, it's all hands on. Because every skin is different. So. Even to this day, I have to set my machines, the speed of my needles, according to how your skin is and where I'm tattooing it.
So tell me about the first tattoo you ever did.
First tattoo I ever did was on my teacher. He had me tattoo some nautical stars on his arm, which was cool because he was able to tell me what to do, what not to do, how deep to go, you know, how much ink to dip. My first real client, I did a panther on his back, and I remember halfway through it, I knew I wasn't doing it right, so you know, my teacher took over. So good thing it was on his back.
Great. great. So how did you actually get out to New York? Like, what was that journey like?
You know, it was hard. I had to leave a lot behind. You know, I had my own shop. You know, I've got a son back in Minneapolis, actually, and I had to, you know, kind of leave all that behind to pursue this dream that I've always had. So it's been hard, you know, but I'm still here, you know. Came out here to work at a shop, and it was great. It was Lower East Side, the oldest shop in town. They've been around since '76, Fine Line Tattoo. And they didn't have many hours for me, and so, you know, looking around, I found another spot, which was in the Village, a brand new shop. I ended up working out there, but after about, you know, 6 months of putting time into that place, I kind of had to part ways with the shop, because they didn't see eye to eye with how I do things. With business people, they just want you to do your job, do your tattoo, and that's it. On to the next one, you know.
So what are your plans now that you're not working at that shop?
You know, other than tattooing clients here in my little studio apartment, I just recently got a new gig. I've got my own place at the Gun Bar over in the Meatpacking District, and I'll be tattooing at the bars. Very excited. You know, have a couple cocktails and step right out.
So tell me about this studio apartment you got set up here.
I've been living here since I moved out here, and I love it. You know, the exposed brick, the old building, the wonderful view that I get. Although I don't have my own kitchen, I don't have my own bathroom, it's for singles only. And I'm okay with that, you know. I've got a fridge, microwave, and I've got Hell's Kitchen right down the street. So it's the people, the action, the busyness, the hustle, you know. That's what I love to see, you know. When I'm having a down and out, you know, time, a day, I can just walk into Times Square and just kind of re-energize myself, you know, just because there's so much, you know, energy there, and that's where I get that.
Do you see yourself staying in New York City long term, or do you see yourself going back to Chicago?
Oh, I love New York City. This is home. This is home. I plan on being here for as long as New York has me. So
that's awesome. What's the most interesting thing about you?
Most interesting about me? Wow. I love to have fun. I love to go out. I love karaoke. I love to dance. At the same time, I love to go to church. So you know, I do all of that while keeping things positive.
All right, so to sum it up, give me your thoughts on New York City.
New York City is amazing. It's full of opportunities, and I didn't know that until now, and I'm still finding that out. New York City will eat you up and spit you out, and you have to prove that you deserve New York City, because once you prove that, New York City will give back to you. With your dream, and I'm living the dream, and I don't see myself anywhere else. This is where I'm supposed to be, and this is where I'm tattooing.
So you love tattooing, obviously. Do you see yourself maybe getting married sometime in the future, or are you kind of the guy that just works?
You know, I love to work. I'm a workaholic, so if I can find a lady that understands that and maybe work alongside with me, maybe someone that that also tattoos would be perfect.
So I take it you like women with tattoos too?
Yeah, yeah.
You think that's sexy?
It is sexy.
Have you ever like tattooed a really sexy girl and was like excited about it?
Oh yeah. Well yeah, I'm about to right now.
Oh, I'm blushing behind the camera, that's so funny. Okay, so John, what are you about to do now?
I'm about to do a tattoo of King of Pop, Michael Jackson.
Are you excited?
I'm super excited.
Alright, so let's see how it comes out.
Alright, let's do it.
She was struck down, it was her doom. natural.